we had heard about it, you know, you hear about other people who go out and play like nights and stuff with big foam sticks.
We've always been intrigued by the dedication of these people to their hobby.
Yes,
but we've never come and seen it up close, so yeah, it's our first time in a way. And seeing the intensity, I think I'd be pretty comfortable doing it.
They seem to enjoy it.
So I don't. I don't know if I have that kind of wardrobe though, or where I would get such a thing.
I wouldn't either.
So there's that.
My name's Peter Cameron. I'm an over-the-road truck driver, and I've been doing this for right at about 12 years now. Out on the field, my name is Nanga Doomspear, and I'm a big monster.
My real name's Hudson Cuss. My character name's Mephit.
My real name's Keith Cameron, and I've been Blix for going on 11 years.
My real name is Lindsay Lewis, and my dagger name
is
Morgan. It means the Phantom Queen again.
My name is Bear. My actual name is David King. My character name, full character name, is Bear of Kodiak.
Hi, I'm Sean Brown, and I go by Badger out here.
My name is Harvey Butler. I use the character name Raki Kalmir's son. I'm 31 years old. I've been in the sport since I was 17 years old. I've seen the sport go through many changes. Our particular area has moved parks twice. We started out at Centennial Park, but due to political differences, we came down to Elmington Park.
Don't hit anybody in the head unless it's an arrow or a javelin, but you should still try not to because it hurts really bad. If you get your arm cut off, you lose a limb, you can still fight. If you get another limb cut off, you're dead, just like that. The rules are pretty easy, and it's just, you really got to pick it up as you come along.
You know, because they just fake getting their arms cut off and their legs cut off, which makes it great.
I'm the president of the nonprofit corporation, chip of the group, about 3 years ago. we're accustomed to people running, driving by and yelling at us every Sunday. And we used to get mad, but we don't get mad anymore. You know?
Yeah, they make fun of us because we look weird, but we're out here having a great time. So I think it takes people who really don't care too much about that and are just really more interested in having a good time.
Hey, now what you gonna do?
We're not freaks. You know, we're not a bunch of sissies running around. You know, I'm wearing 25 pounds of leather, you know, and I'm able to move as fast as anybody out here, so I don't really consider myself to be a sissy or a wimp, just because I dress differently and I have a different sport.
Garb is basically just the clothing that we wear when we're out here. It has aspects that show that we are a member of different units.
This is one of my weapons. All that it is pull it apart a little bit. Fiberglass, fence post as the center, as the core. And then this stuff is just blue camping pad from Walmart. Rather than somebody just showing up with, you know, a stick wrapped in foam with duct tape, you know, I mean, that is more or less what they are, but they're specifically made sticks wrapped in foam with duct tape, so.
Right now my weapon of choice is probably a shield and a flail. I also use a long sword. I used to fight with a two-handed sword and nothing else, but it's really hard to compete in a sport like this without it, without a shield and some armor. I heard somebody say once that Thor wouldn't go to Valhalla without a shield. It's like being a minor league player in the major leagues if you don't have the right equipment.
Thank you.
most of my really good friends that I've met in life have come out of this sport. I mean, it's a nationwide thing. I know people in all kinds of different states and cities. I mean, there's a lot of people that do this, and it's a great way to forge new relationships by beating each other up.